Everyone, my name is Ian Van Tile, and behind me is our new 2018 Jeannot 349 Sun Odyssey. So let me show you some of the features that this yacht has to offer. All right, so we're on this Mark Lombard design, Jeannot 349, and this particular vessel we've ordered in with the bowsprit option. So you can see the bowsprit option is quite trick. I mean, it really sets the looks of it, the vessel off. We have a really plumb bow. And so what the bowsprit option does is it enables you to have your tack point out far forward from your furling head sail. So it's quite nice if you're flying a Code Zero, asymmetrical spinnaker, and it really gives you a lot of those capabilities. The second thing it does is it brings the anchor roller a little further off of the bow. And I really like that on the plumb bow. It just gives you a little bit more forgiveness. But as we move aft, we're gonna have a full anchor locker here. This anchor locker has a quick electric windlass in it, and it really provides a great space for all of your chain and road. We have flush hatches here on the cabin tops. We have really innovative and sleek design. So this has a cambered deck, right? So we all know what cambered decks are, or cambered is. You know, what it does is it actually brings up the camberness in the cabin top, in the vessel, in the salon, and you're gonna see down below just how much volume that actually gives you, not to mention phenomenal stylish lines. So as we move back aft, you're gonna notice we've also brought this vessel in with the classic mainsail. So this is the full Baden classic mainsail. As you can see, it has the stack pack here, which makes it very easy. All you gotta do is drop the halyard and it goes right into the stack pack here. You kind of bunch up the sail, close the bag. I mean, that is it. You're getting all the performance. You're getting ease of sailing handling with this stack pack. As we move back aft, again, you're gonna notice the stainless steel grab handles, how all the sheets and lines are really nicely organized leading into the cockpit. And like what most Jeannots do, they really focus on single-handed use, short-handed use. They bring the jib sheet, they bring the main sheet back to each helm. I mean, this is a fast performance, you know, could be a cruiser, it could be a racer, but again, the whole idea of having a vessel that's easy to single hand, easy to use, is really what Jeannot's motto is. And that's what they've done here. So jib sheet, main sheet, that's on both helms. We have a really nice steering wheel here, great visual aspects. One other thing that I like is the amount of stowage that they've dedicated here in the cockpit, which is quite unusual for a vessel of this size. The other technical features of this vessel, we have injected molded decks. We're stronger, we're lighter weight, we drop the center of gravity down lower. We're really focusing on stability. The other main key point to stability is the hard chine. You're gonna notice the hard chine on the 349 starts about 3/4 of the way up and brings it very far aft. For those of you who don't really know what the hard chine is, that is this squared out transom right here. So what happens is the vessel heels over and just sits there right on that hard chine, and really just takes off. It excels. Instead of plowing over, slowing down, it actually excels the vessel. So a really nice innovation here. The other nice cruising aspect to this boat, or comfort creatures, look at this fold down transom. I mean, this is a massive fold down transom for a 34-foot vessel. We have a built-in integrated swim step ladder here. We actually have a hot and cold swim step shower. There's cockpit speakers. Again, additional stowage. We have a GPS Raymarine plotter off to the port helm, and look at this. Notice that, you know, most performance boats, they have sheets, they have halyards, they have everything, but there's actually a dedicated spot for those sheets and halyards. I really love it. We have our throttle controls off to the starboard side, our autopilot, multi-repeaters, and everything, again, is integrated into the chart plotter. So you can actually activate the autopilot from the chart plotter itself. So you don't need two instrumentations on both sides. Centrally located is our T cockpit table. The T cockpit table has leaves on both sides and it is quite nice. As we move up forward to the cabin top, you're gonna notice that we have additional hull ports here that are opening. We have two hull ports underneath each one of the seats. Now what that does is in the aft master, you're gonna give you great ventilation and it's gonna give you light. And then we also have a sail locker that you can actually stow stuff down into. So it's quite nice. But two cabin top winches here. We have the companionway doors that really, you know, open up lock into place via magnets. It's quite nice. Notice that we have a really low door sill here. So the CE characteristics of this, because you have, you know, doors that can be closed in a matter of seconds, it allows you to drop that door sill. So let's go down below and see what it has to offer. All right, so as we come down below, one thing I want to point out to you is this real nice, again, gradual steps coming into the salon of the vessel. This is actually the very first Jeanneau 349 with the light oak interior. So, I mean, this is actually my first time seeing this. I'm really impressed. I love the, you know, the two-tone fabrics that they've chosen here and the countertops. It is quite nice. So the galley has a single stainless steel sink with a really nice faucet system here. We also have a top-loading refrigerator with small freezer compartment. So this is really set up nicely. Just above that, we have a additional stowage. I mean, look at the attention to detail. Look at this, you know, hinges so it doesn't slam down. I mean, it's just very well thought out. We have a microwave with a turntable inside of it. Lots of cabinetry, you know, above, below. We have a two-burner stove and oven. And again, lots of subsill storage, lots of storage here for a galley of this size. Directly behind me is our aft stateroom. The aft stateroom is a modified queen berth. It has a hanging walker closet. We have an opening hatch that goes into the cockpit to let a lot of natural light in and additional ventilation. We also have a side port that allows you to have great visual outside of the vessel as well. As we move back up forward, we're gonna look at the head. Now, the head of this vessel has been very well thought out. We have a single stainless steel sink with a nice angled beveled mirror. Just below that is a cabinetry with stowage, and then we have a Jabsco toilet. Just aft of that toilet is a shower stall with a smoked glass divider. The smoked glass divider is quite nice because you can actually separate the head from the shower. This is a dry head. This is, again, very well thought out. We have nice appointments, nice fixtures here. What I really like too is behind me, behind through the shower, this gives you full access into the storage compartment. Now, this can be used as an additional berth if you so desire, but it is a phenomenal stowage compartment to house the cockpit cushions, blow up kayaks, blow up dinghy, you know, your barbecue, anything that you can think of that you might possibly need. Extra sails, a very, very well laid out vessel. As we move up forward into the salon, you're going to also see that, again, from that cambered effect that I was talking to you about, it really raises up here. Again, I'm 6 foot, so it gives you a good perspective of headroom, and it really opens it up. We have beautiful windows up on the cabin top, very large windows in the port, seating on both sides, the table leaves fold up, so you could be at each one of the benches and be able to sit at the salon table. I really like that, or have one up, one down. The nav station itself is set up quite nicely. We have our 110, our 12 volt panel. We also have our fuel gauge. By lifting this switch, it'll actually show us our fuel capacity, VHF and Fusion stereo controllers. There are two video speakers here in the salon and two in the cockpit as well too. As we move up, we can see we have a double door. Now this double door really opens the space up. It really makes this vessel feel large, wide, inviting, open, and it's a phenomenal design in my opinion. We have a really nice large V-berth up forward. Behind the door we have a full hanging locker closet, and behind the starboard door we have a bench seat where you can sit down and put on your shoes and so forth. But it's a great cabinet. The other thing I like is all of the lighting that they do here. There's LED up lighting. There's LED lighting that's over the grab handles in the salon. And again, with today's technology, it's set up quite nicely. Well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. This particular vessel is for sale. It's currently located in San Diego. We typically move the yachts from our Bay Area office, Marina Del Rey or San Diego. So contact me at any time, day or night, to get aboard. I'm here for you. You could call me, text me, email me. My phone's on 24/7. I look forward to hearing from you, hopefully earning your business and getting you on this amazing vessel. Thank you again.